Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whatever time zone you're in or whatever time zone you're watching this. This is the WiX Online Meeting number 30. It's a nice big round number. It's like we've been doing this for a while. If you think it every week for a while, it's pretty cool, huh? Yeah? June 2014, halfway through this month, mostly the way through this year. Anyway, these meetings are recorded. For those people that are unable to be here, always want to put that disclaimer up front. I don't think we have a real long meeting. Maybe we'll have some discussion because at this point, I just have some triage, and then we'll do questions and comments, things that people want to talk about in the end. Sounds good? Ready, Bob?
I'm ready.
All right, here we go. Off to the web to do triage. We have a few bugs, but some of these are just things coming back, so we'll go back to this thing that was in 4, and yeah, so Heath said that this should be fixed in that, and this is the bug about planning, right, where I kept saying that this should work, and people kept telling me it didn't work. And that someone's, I think Keith's finally getting around to fixing it due to all the other things they were doing, right?
That is what it says.
He doesn't agree. Sean doesn't agree that they're the same. Does Sean have audio capability? Oh no, I just lost my mouse. Can you unmute Sean from the web?
Yes, I can.
All right. Would you mind doing that? And I'm curious what Sean wants to say about this not being the same.
First, when I say I can, it doesn't mean I'm going to be fast at it. Because
mouse so hard to use. Did your cat eat?
Oh, there we go. No, I just have to find it.
All
plus,
right.
I have to pick. Oh, no, there's only one Sean. All right.
Yeah, there's only one Sean this time around. We do have a bunch of other duplicates due to the meeting crashing.
Sean, you should be unmuted.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, so let's say you want to do the install action and you want to cache an XE package. You can't do that today, and his change doesn't fix that.
Okay, cool. So then you're right. They're not the same. Because what you said should work also is that you should be able to say, I want to cache one package and install another and uninstall another, and the right thing should happen. That should all work correctly. And so if it doesn't, that would be this bug. That's fine with me.
And actually the bug that, or the feature that Heath points to is the controversial one. That's the one that adds a top level cache action. So, yeah, I agree. I think this is...
well, there should have been cache action before?
I don't think there was a install and repair were top-level actions. I don't think there was a top-level cache action.
There should have been. Yeah, that's just a bug.
But, yeah, and I think this, the bug on the screen right now is, I think, just one of those things that the engine supports, but currently there's just not the right piping to get it around.
Okay.
So
clearly I'm the only person that thinks that this works, and everybody else is proving that I'm just wrong. All right, sounds fine. So this bug is not fixed. Let's add that comment that this particular issue is not yet fixed by that other issue, although they are all the correct direction to be heading. Does that mean that we could fix this in 3X?
It depends. If this is what I'm recalling, and there is no guarantee that that's the case, this is something the BA can't currently request, so we have to add something.
No, request date cache is available, so you should be able to return request date cache on the request date of any package. It's just today it always treats it as none, which is not correct. It should treat it as cache. Not install, and maybe uninstall, right? Cache should basically be a step below installed, but a step higher than absent.
That makes sense.
Which exists. I mean, that exists in there. All right, so this isn't working. I think we could take this in 3X. The only breaking change is that if you were asking for state cache in the past, you were getting none, and now suddenly you would get caching, which arguably is what you wanted. So it's just kind of like, oh, well, I was passing cache, and then suddenly it started working. We'd be like, yeah, we finally fixed the bug. They'd be like, well, Well, I expected to keep returning none. We're like, if you wanted none, then return none.
That seems reasonable, yes.
So I think this could go back to 3x now that we understand them separate from the planning thing, which is off.
No, I agree.
Sean, did I say anything that sounded really dumb there?
Since no, that's fine.
All right.
I mean,
I've sounded dumb on this bug many times because I thought it worked.
I mean, I guess the backwards compatibility line is kind of blurry sometimes.
Well,
this one I'm fine with saying, you know, something that was obviously a bug. I don't want to get to the point where we're like Windows where, you know,
yeah,
we need app compat shims to maintain buggy behavior.
Yeah, no.
Plus, I don't think there are enough. Well, there's a lot of managed BAs out there, but not so many that I'm to that point of paranoia about back compat.
Yeah. Well, and again, it's clearly busted.
Yeah.
I reset cache and it did none. Okay.
So I'll keep doing it.
None is none. All right. I've lost my mouse cursor, so hopefully I can. Yes, I can get around in here. Okay, here we go. Interop assemblies. All right. So Cooper has looked at this. By the way, there's a guy on the Sounders called Kenny Cooper, and he was on a hack trick last night. He did awesome. It was fun to watch. They won 5-0 against an amateur team. So, I mean, they were supposed to win. But anyway, I can go find highlights if people are interested.
Undoubtedly.
not related, bummer. Yeah, Cooper's pretty common, so that would be pretty hard to be. I wouldn't expect that to be common. Anyway, he's a good guy, too. Making assembly copy local works well or better than the proposed target. Okay, yes, that's not. Custom action contents could also extend what is included in the package. This is not. I don't understand why you'd want PDBs.
Would make it easier to debug custom actions.
Oh, they put them in the right directory? Is that what it's saying?
Yeah.
I see.
Yeah, they're like dependencies. But in that way.
All right, so copy local works. Got it. Copy local. Good. So copy local works. So I don't think this is a bug. So the rest that this turns into is a feature to move PDBs around.
Agreed.
Great. So let's kill this bug and someone can open a feature request to pull the PDBs around. And the right answer to this is mark the thing as copy local, which is the standard way of doing this. Right, John? Right, that's right. Yes. All right, cool. So this bug goes away, and someone can go open the feature request about copying PDBs, which is a matter of updating the WiX CI targets to move the PDBs to the direct location. Right?
That was me. From my perspective, yes. Sweet. I don't want to add that to the project.
And then you can decide whether you want to take that in 3.9.
Yeah.
All right, cool. So let's go open that feature. John, can we put that on you again since you've been doing such a great job of running this thing already? Sweet! John's going to go open another feature. But do it in, like, you know, 30 minutes. Bundles are not uninstalled if there are no packages to plan. That doesn't sound good.
No.
This is bad. This should work.
No Heath today. Though that was separate from his related bundle bug. This is bad.
So I vote we keep this in 3.9 and hopefully someone hunts this down and kills it. I don't know where it went wrong, but it should work. It has to work. Because if all your packages get uninstalled for some reason, you need to be able to remove the bundle.
Yeah.
So, yeah. It'd be nice if there's a log file in here, someone that would show it, but.
Yes, that would be nice.
Yeah, look, plan this. Didn't do anything, see? But whatever.
Yeah, I'll assign it to myself. I'll see if I can. No, I'm not assigning it to the triage team. I'll assign it to me and follow up with Heath. Maybe there's, because he's talking about he ran into it during testing. So if there's a scenario that I can repro this with the tests, that would be helpful.
Yeah. Heath is unable to handle registry key removal on .reg files. Sure. It's not a bug. It's a feature. It's not going to 3.8. You can put it in 3x.
Yep. Agree with that.
Feature in 3x. Someone could go right there if they wanted. Auto-generation GUI should not be prevented by version companion files. You shouldn't have version companion files.
Yeah.
Why would you have version companion files? That just seems so wrong.
I know.
It
is legal according to MSI. I think it's weird.
It's very weird.
Like,
here's a version file, but it's not version by this version. It's version by another random file that you won't be able to see.
It is actually an interesting workaround for downgrading.
Yeah, it's...
But it's, yeah. Yep.
I agree with this. Is this only if the companion file's versioned?
It's only a problem if they're versioned, because
unversioned companion files are okay.
Unversioned companion files and unversioned non-companion files are okay.
Okay. Good. Seriously?
I'm. My inclination is to, well, at the very most, this is such an odd case that I don't want to gum up the StarGUID works with cases like this. Yeah, it's legal, but it's so bizarre that I don't care.
I wonder why he has disk ID on the file.
IntelliSense.
Let me fill in everything. Oh, yeah, he has the names, even though they're the same as the source. So yeah. And the ID, even though it's the same as the name. Anyway. This makes my head hurt. Having a hard time getting over the fact the version component file. Companion file. The version companion file.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, what did you do? You screwed up your versioning somewhere. Someone screwed up their versioning somewhere.
And this is a potential fix for it. Which is all good
but
and true.
It's a really bad fix long term. Right, because that file 2 DLL finally gets fixed, you're in a bad place.
Yeah. Actually, the patching implications are interesting.
Your future implications are interesting, too.
Yeah, I don't want this. I don't want this to work.
Yeah, I have a hard time defending it in a big way. It's like, yeah, don't do this. If you do this, put a GUID on it, and suddenly the whole thing looks scary.
Yeah.
It's like, yeah, you get to manage the GUID on this thing because you're just doing really scary things here.
Yeah. Truthfully, that is part of it. Star GUIDs are it's a lot like major upgrade.
Yeah.
You know, the original intent behind major upgrade was to simplify the 80% cases.
Yep.
And we ruined it, because including I helped ruin it, by adding a bunch of silly edge cases. Now, major upgrade, you can still do the simplest thing, but it has all these other attributes that you have to sort through to figure it out. And I think that ruined the simplicity. Star GUIDs need to be simple, and they need to be rock solid. So I'm concerned about the implications of...
Yeah, no. I'm with you, and I'm with John. He says it should look scary. I think you're right. I think the answer is, yeah, what you're doing here is scary. You should put a GUID on it. This whole thing, we're not going to make your life easy doing this.
Yeah, yeah.
And in fact, we probably should have a warning saying, you're putting a companion file on a version file.
Right.
That's generally a bad idea. So at least then they're also dealing with the warning, which I would be okay with. I'm going to be like, I want to suppress that warning. Well, you can suppress the warning, but you had to see it at least once.
Yeah.
I just don't want people feeling good about this, basically, is what it comes down to.
you've done something bad. You should feel bad, and you're a bad person.
Yeah. So I'm with you, Bob. I think we can say no to that one. Util remove folder property doesn't modularize. Okay, so it should be. Seems reasonable.
Yeah, probably. Whatever. Merge module
sweet. Heat throws error on Win 7. Really? Well, that error is pretty crappy. So, yeah, we should at least catch it and do something better. Whoa, wait. It's trying to display a message. It actually has an exception when it's trying to display a message?
I didn't even notice console.
So it failed to write to console.
How does that fail?
Handle is invalid. It's like they did a redirect on the heat there to something that it didn't like redirecting to. I'm not exactly sure how you get it to do that.
Wow.
No idea.
Is it error or just out?
I think it's standard out. I don't think we display our messages as standard error.
Oh, that's right. We don't. So, well, there's a bug on that somewhere, actually.
Yeah, but I think we don't because
most other tools don't.
MS Build doesn't like it or something. I forget how that worked, but anyway. I forget. Anyway, whatever. I never really cared. So we're trying to write the display to the console message handler, which should just be doing console out at that point. So. MS Build can capture error, but we do really kooky things in the way that we load the assemblies, John, into MS Build. It's very, very kooky for performance, and there's because of that, it does weird things. Anyway, I'm sure we could fix it. It's not as simple as, hey, we'll just write the console out, or console error. Anyway, so console streams is failing, so something really bad is happening here. Because that's all just write. Like, that's not even processing the message arg, so it's not like our code's even doing anything here. I don't know what we do with this bug. I guess we put it in 3x and say, this is weird. This isn't a global thing, though. Yeah, so no one else can repro it. We need more information. Yeah, all right. So how about we add that to the bug? How about we just go, Other people are not having this issue. This issue is saying that the executable cannot write the console out. Did you do something to console out? Or is that command line? Because I bet his command lines were missing something there. Like, and he's piping it to something or something. Although, wait, we got console out here, right? Because this is console out. I don't know what happened here. I have no idea. I don't know. This is weird. Someone has to go look at this on this machine. Yeah, John, I know what you're saying, except if he got the header, then he wrote something to the screen. It's like, and he got the error, the unhandled exception, so something got written to him. Unless we actually are redirecting to standard error, like, I don't know, did we take that fix somewhere? Because I know that Blair was pushing for that and did something, and then maybe that's what's happening.
I don't think we took it anywhere, because it would break anyone who was, you know, manually redirecting.
Someone could go look at the code real quick, right? Console message handler display. Anyway, what do we want to do with this bug? I really don't like it when people use WSX. I hope that's just a typo when he transposed this command line here.
I know, that bugs me too. But I suppose we shouldn't reject the bug just because of that.
No. Maybe it's someone has a little bit of dyslexia and so they're struggling with that. Anyway, what do we do with this bug? I don't even know what to do with it. Plenty of people don't have this problem.
Yeah.
Have a nice day. No. That's not nice.
I don't know. And also, it's kind of impossible, you know, he mentions Windows 7, but that's not it.
Probably not it, no.
And other people use Windows 7.
Maybe it's Windows 7 RTM with .NET Framework 4.5.2. I got everybody to smile. Hey, I'm doing all right this morning. My jokes are landing today. This is awesome.
Well.
All right, okay. You are a tough bar, all right? I'm not. You do not count.
I've been told that before. I don't know what to do with this bug. I mean, truthfully, I would normally say, yeah, it works here. Does it only fail on a particular machine?
You could also kick this back to the user group and say, hey, let's go. You need to go search this thing down before we open a bug on it. Because it could just be your machine kind of thing.
But I mean, that's if you can't write to the console, that's a sign, man.
Yes. We should add that to the bug and basically say, this error is saying that the tool cannot write to console. It's not a problem in heat. It's a problem in writing the console. And now I'm tired of guessing. I'm going to open a window and go look and see if we actually took standard error or not. Because
console not write line, man.
Oh, you looked?
Yeah.
All right, then.
In fact, but I'm also like, where's our text writer?
We don't have a text writer. It's just console write line underneath it uses text writer.
Not in the stack.
Well, that's a good point.
Unless he's running a debug build, which calls debugger, also not in the stack, but.
Alright. I'm time boxing this bug. Pick something. We're moving on. So, a lot of other people are not having an issue with this bug. This is basically saying it can't write to console or something to that effect. Let's go have a discussion on Wix users and see if it's your machine or your. Or what? Yes, no, maybe?
Yeah, that's fine. I like that.
Or do you want to put them on Wix devs and to hunt the bug down? You pick there.
If there's only one report, then this is clearly, you know, some kind of cosmic ray situation. I think Wix users is probably the best to see if there's anything else.
Fine by me. The only problem with Wix users and me right now is that on my information diet, Wix users gets processed about once every 3 weeks. For me. So if other people are hanging out there, that's all good. So that's all.
It's fine. I mean,
okay. You'll see it, then I'm happy with that.
I can say, well, I'll probably see it, and I can also say, report back.
Right. All right. Da-da-da-da, that bug goes away, and we are done, assuming John didn't type anything yet. Yay. All right. We'll do yours next week, John, assuming you type it between now and then, which is a lot of hours for you to get that done. All right. Are we done here?
Yes. Well, actually, we can triage 3-9.
3-9. Oh, you want to do that? Oh, see, that's not on the, that is not on the agenda today.
It's still triage.
Run async elevator process after install. Sean, has he resent that yet?
I believe so.
Okay. Yes. All right. That got resent.
Okay.
I
saw a bunch of, I saw like 30 comments go back and forth. Sean, is everything resolved? To your satisfaction, at least?
Well, yeah, and, yeah. Some, okay. The,
okay.
At some point, we should just go, typos can be fixed in a subsequent pull request.
Yeah. No, I don't think it was typos. He had, well, there were probably some typos, but other stuff.
Jacob, no, Jacob, I when I took Heath's change, I did a full build and got all my stuff. Everything went through clean. And then I did a build on Monday, and it is out there. So the build
Me
machine
too.
And my machine were happy. So, Jacob.
And mine.
It sounds like it's you. Sorry.
Although you're running just Visual Studio 2012, I'm running only 2013. Build machine has all of them.
And my machine has all of them.
Okay.
My machine might still have 2008 on it, for all I know.
Oh man, how can you stand that?
I don't use it. It's just sitting there.
I know, but how can you tolerate its presence?
I needed to build 3.8 and 3.7.
Yeah, not 3.8.
Or 3.7, whatever it was.
Yeah, anyway, 3.7.
It goes back a ways. Anyway.
So, it's just you, Jacob.
Yeah, it's just
Nothing
you.
Personal.
All right, so we need to go do Sean's thing. This one, I need to go look at Heath's changes, because I'm wondering if he picked this up in another fix of his. So I need to go reevaluate the world in that. So it's going to take a little bit more. I just haven't had a chance to do that, but I will. And if it happens, then I probably gonna need to follow up with Heath, because it's going to be like, so we're doing this. Why haven't you hit this yet? All right. So light throws exception if access is denied. We have a pull request for this. We're just waiting for assignment agreement, I assume.
That's all I'm waiting for.
Okay. 452 EULA, still you, and whatever we get there. I'm sorry, this is still my machine. I decided to do the build instead of push my own pull request. I figured that was more valuable since people did a lot of work over the weekend.
Very true.
All right, but I have this. I just have to clean it, make sure it's clean, and push it. So it's really straightforward. Bundle self update. I assume Jacob's build issues are preventing him from finishing that. Yes. Yes, Jacob. Yes, good. So we will keep talking about that, I'm sure, as he has build issues. Just to clean up. Right. So let's get the cleanup done. So continue to push your build issues. If you continue to have them, unknown build issues, send them to Wix devs. Maybe we can help. As you work through it. Add burn support for only caching packages. I assume this is the pull request that everybody wants me to look at.
Yes.
All right.
Yep, that's the one.
I just haven't got to it yet, but I will have time now. I just didn't. Bundle's not uninstalled, and that's the one we just pulled in today.
Yep. Okay, cool.
So we know about all this stuff. I'm a little worried about your date, but your date is kind of artificial at this point. So I mean, it's not tied to a holiday, which makes it artificial. That's why.
Yeah, that's a problem. We're going to miss July 4th. So, now it is kind of.
I'm actually a little bit worried about all that stuff that came over the weekend. I was just like, I ended up with like 160 messages in my inbox. I was just like, this is just discussion on. I was like, oh my god.
That's
not an RC build on Monday. I'll build it, but that's not an RC build.
No, it's definitely not. The good news there is that most of those changes, I've already looked at.
Yeah, and you parsed
in another context, and they've been, they've gotten beat up by actual users. So
yeah, there's that advantage. All right, so that's all. It's not too bad.
Yep.
Not too bad.
Yep.
Need to get Sean's and then Jacob's and my little thing. Mines are so small, it's not even worth talking about. And then I need to go do a pull request, so cool. All right.
That works.
Okay. So I think that is triage all done. By the way, for those of you here, I just learned that triage also includes reviewing WiX 3.9 issues. So.
Triaging WiX 3.9 issues.
All right. Questions, comments? I guess that gives me more impetus to go make sure that there are no more 3.9 issues, because I don't really feel like triaging those all the time. Anyway, grumpy. Questions, comments, things going on out there. Jacob already asked about his build issues. If you have more things, we need to go get those fixed. Sean's got his stuff in. John's going to go open his feature request. Donnie's back after being absent for quite a while. I just want to say that. Bruce is now called Landshark. I don't know what else I got. That's about it. Jacob thinks he wants to talk about something. I think we have to make it such that every time that Bruce joins a call, and he's here twice now, that he has to enter and say, Landshark.
Well, I want to take advantage of the fact that we have, twins and triplets this week and, sign out lots of bugs.
I think they're ghosts. Like, they're not real here. All right. And have you? Yeah, seriously, Donnie. Now you have to do is, I don't know if you already have a assignment, but you should get that. And then you should start picking up bugs and fixing stuff and things. Although, we always enjoy people hanging out, so we'll just stress test Link. Anyway, I'm babbling at this point. I can give you people 20 minutes back of your very busy lives unless anybody likes things. Didn't like the upgrade either. I don't know. Oh, Link upgrade. So people got a Link upgrade pushed. Oh, the web thingy? Yeah. All right. I used the client, which makes my life easier, sort of. But
you're the only one who can.
Am I?
Oh, sorry. No, some people have been able to do it. I've never been able to get in through the Link client.
Yeah. Well, everybody that had upgrade their clients, go reboot your machines. It'll probably be better. Seems to be the favorite fix from those guys, too. We had some issues with Link and Fire Giant, and they're like, oh, yeah, just reboot. And we're like, seriously? Of course, we're sitting here going, guys, we may be able to help you with your installation issues. It's so weird having conversations with people when their stuff fails to install, and we're like, maybe we could help you. All right. Anything else? Anything else? We're all babbling about Link, which is always a fun topic. But whatever. Anything else? Anything else?
That's all I got.
All you got. I could ask an unrelated question. Yeah, unrelated question to, like, it's still in the WiX remain, because,
I was
not going
to
tell you
Mike.
What color socks you should wear today. test case projects. Yes, we have test case projects, and Heath has been doing a lot of work to fix them after I did a block of work to move them to XUnit and things like that. Yes, and get some of them fixed. Should they not have the same validation as the standard WiX ones? Test case projects, should they? I make sure warnings are errors. I'm fine with that. There's a little bit of history. We got a lot of test code from random places. Like, we would have like back in the old days, some random teams at Microsoft would be like, oh, we need to use Wix, but it doesn't have a whole bunch of test cases, so we wrote a whole bunch of test code and dumped it on us. And so we ended up with a lot of like infrastructure code. If you look at the Wix test code, it's just gobs and got like there's more test infrastructure code than there is tests. And it just turned into this thing, and we had someone trying to sort it out, but then I guess they gave up. They actually transferred to a new team and all kinds of stuff. So anyway, it's all kind of a mess, and so I think it would be great if they were up to the same standard and same coding convention. I don't even think it has that in it and all that kind of stuff, but I don't think we were there, and rather than just hose the world and give it nothing, then it would be nice to like get it to a good place. So if you, yeah, but, all right. So Jacob, if you hit a block of code and it's bad or it doesn't make any sense, fix it. Clearly, if you remove something that is not used and it doesn't break anything, that's awesome. And hopefully we'll catch it in pull requests. We should catch it in pull requests and stuff if it does that. Right. Well, it compiles in the configuration that we have for the test code. But like I said, also, the test code is old and needs to be cleaned. So if you found something that needs to be cleaned that makes it run better and things like that, I'm all for it. It is entirely possible that somewhere you have a setting that is globally turning on warnings as errors and we don't. I don't know how that's possible, but I don't know. All I can tell you is that everybody else is able to build. But again, if you find dead code, I'm all for removing it if we can.
Jacob, are you getting the failure during a build of Wix.proj at the root or when you're in the test tree?
Oh, yeah, building.
I'm just.
Only building from the root is what we tend to do. Oh. Yeah, don't do that. Sorry. We all build Wix.proj and. Oh, okay. Well, that's fine. All right, good. You're building from root, which is what you should be doing. Like, if that works, then you're in a good spot.
Yeah. I mean, test.proj is what Wix.proj calls, so.
To build.
Yeah, it should be fine.
Yeah.
And I can build from the root of the test tree.
Once you build all the way up front, so. Yeah, only static data members can be initialized inside a ref class value type. Is it possibly like a bad merge locally or something? I don't know. Well, all right. What line is that? I can look on my code real quick.
I have that field.
Oh, okay.
But I don't get the
error. You looked. Okay.
Yeah. I'm not sure.
Maybe you're building 2013, which is more generous with that.
I am building with 2013.
At that point, that's like the only variable left, because Wix will pick the highest compiler you have, and if his highest is 2012, then he would be getting different set of compilers than we have. And that is in managed C++ code stuff. So that is the one area that is still pretty wonky in the compiler land, or they continue to do things that are wonky.
Jacob, try just building from a normal command shell.
Yeah.
You don't actually need the prompt and all the setup.
Yeah, because Wix sets all that stuff up for you. Because we build in so many different Visual Studios the same path, so.
Yeah. I'm wondering if it is a setting.
Mm-hmm.
Again, I'm not sure how the. I don't know. If you had like a default response file somewhere. I don't know.
I got nothing.
Oh wait, actually. Worth a look is C8 3845. Is that a warning or an error? Huh? Does it's an error.
Yeah, and Bruce has a point, because Bruce did work to get the whole passing that figured out that we had to pass Visual Studio version, right? And all that, or whatever, Visual Studio version equals whatever in 2012, because MS Build did something kooky that we had to work around, and yeah.
Interesting.
I think they did some things in 2012 that they fixed in 2013. Like, broke some things in 2012. Very hard to get a 2012 machine only, because that's such a, if Visual Studio 2010 is going to be the XP of Visual Studio, then 2012 is definitely going to be the Vista.
Well, mostly because it was quickly replaced.
The Vista. The Vista of Visual Studio.
It's not that it was bad.
Dude, the fact that we had to pass version 11, Visual Studio version equals 11.0 on the command prompt was not fun. The fact that that was even an issue.
I'll go there, yeah.
All right. Well, in the end, I'm like, look, it's an unreferenced thing. Pull it.
I'm wondering if this doesn't get built with the default projects, except somehow. Well, now there's one where all the test changes going through. You might have gotten a bad merge. Try cloning into a different directory and diffing. I'm wondering if maybe the projects are okay.
Good. Jacob's one step ahead of you there.
Yeah, I was gonna say, brilliant ideas. Right, yes.
Oh, yeah, but what Bob's saying is pull a clean WiX3 develop down.
Yeah, and it's an entirely separate directory. Don't try to merge or mess up your existing repo.
Pull clean new clone and see if it fails there too. Because if so, then what you probably have is a failure we don't know about today about 2012 interaction. Because I'm pretty sure, well, I'm not sure anybody else has just 2012 or as 2012 as their top Visual Studio version.
Yeah, that's interesting. Yeah, of the people regularly building Wix,
Of people building with, yeah.
most probably have 2013 as their high.
Right. Which means we'd be using those compilers.
Right. Although technically, the MSDN says it's an error in both versions. Public ref, yeah. Yeah, it matches all the criteria for the error.
Well, and Jacob, I'm kind of like, if people add code wrong all the time because they're people, so I'm inclined to just go, well, looks like this was a mistake. Call it out in a separate pull request and go from there at a certain level. You're like, honestly, that's the easiest thing to do is go, this looks wrong and it fails to build in this configuration. Well, I'm not against you there. I'm glad you like to root cause it too. At some point though, productivity does take over, especially on something as, I guess I have a lower bar for managed C++ root causing because it's always been a little bit off. It's awesome to be able to unit test our native code, but that's about as far as I'm willing to go with it. So, I mean, I guess my point is, it's just starting to impact the WiX 3.9 window. so it might just be, punt, come back later.
Yeah, it's definitely, I just built it. And did a rebuild to see.
And if you delete that line, it builds fine too, right? So it's not like you have code that referenced it and he has code that somehow doesn't reference it.
I don't know. Yeah, I agree. It's a little wonky. My assumption was that somewhere it was just, it wasn't actually building the code for some reason. But what does that icon mean?
Does FXCOP work on managed C++ code?
FXCOP uses the actual assemblies, right? So it should.
FXCOP is a real pain in the butt to deal with, so because we went so long without having such a thing.
Yeah.
So I don't know. Not that it says we shouldn't have it, but just takes work to get there. That's a whole different project. All right, we got anything else? We're getting close to our hour. People hanging out.
Nothing for me. Today I'll probably do four requests.
Cool. I expect to be able to get to the things that people are asking me to look at tonight.
Yeah, I'd be good. I'm... I don't want to prejudice you.
I'll look at it.
I haven't. I'd like your
I'm not against the feature. This is that async bundle feature, right?
Yes.
Yeah, I'm not against the feature. I mean, it's kind of interesting what they've done there. I have to think about it.
I'm mostly okay with it because this is the first you add the caching support and then you add async.
Right.
And that's what they're doing.
Yes. So, but caching should have just worked. So, the fact that's just like fixing an issue in my head. Right.
Okay. Yeah. This was the adding the top level cache action.
Right. In my mind, that should have worked already. So, yeah.
Oh, I see. Okay.
The ability to call plan and say cache and have a bundle do nothing except cache all of its bits was a design. It was supposed to work. Now, I haven't looked at how they implemented it. Like, that could be wrong, but it was supposed to work.
Okay.
And so, anyway, I need to go spend some time in that. Like, obviously, for the last, I don't know how many weeks, we've been talking about this feature that I keep saying, this should work! And people keep going, but it doesn't! And I have not... obviously, it's horrible, bad on me, should need to go in and look at why it doesn't work and go, and figure out just how far off my memory is from reality and go, this doesn't work at all. Or, no, see, you just had to fix this one line and it would have worked. Anyway, we'll see.
It is generally a good idea to, do that every once in a while.
Well,
just to check in with your,
memory? Yeah.
Check in with your brain.
I have way too much stuff loaded, though, so it's hard to do all that. So on that note, before I fill it up, I think we're done here. Sean and Jacob are talking to each other. I don't know if we're going to get anything else that we have to discuss there.
Yeah, I have that line too. It's weird.
Well, and can you delete it and build it, Bob? Like, does it work? If you delete that line and build it, like, that means that nothing refers to it, which means that the error would be true. And then you're looking for some chase someplace somewhere in the build targets that remove that error from our suppress list or something.
Yeah, rebuilds, all the tests rebuild.
Okay. Jacob special. Maybe Jacob gets to be our Visual Studio 2010. I assume there's a command line option somewhere that Jacob's asking how you suppress an error, and it's like, I think you can suppress, oh, maybe you can suppress warnings? I always forget. Can you suppress error numbers? I think you
not
can
an
do
actual
pragma
error,
error.
right?
Can you not do pragma error and then a number? I haven't, now that I think about it, I don't know that I've tried in a long time.
How, if it's an actual error, how would you suppress that? What would it do?
It would suppress it and you'd keep going. And something would be happy.
It would
in it.
make magic code instead?
Yeah, well, you know, well,
depends on the error, of course.
I have a hard time with this thing being an error. It seems like it's a warning, but it's like, you have a field that's initialized. Although, yeah, I don't know. I give up. You guys win. I know nothing about this. I'm going to quit talking about it. Hopefully Jacob figures it out, or we just move on, honestly. Yeah, rainbows, unicorns, whatever. works on my machine.
Yeah.
I'm done with that. All right. Well, as always, gentlemen, because it's still, I think, all gentlemen, good times. I'm going to get these videos posted today or tomorrow, because it's been a while since I've got them all posted, which is not good, but yeah, whatever. It's been exciting times. I'm getting lots of things done and all that kind of good stuff. So I hope you guys are productive, having a good time. We're having great discussions out there on the Wix Dev mailing list. If you're not following along, you should be. If you're not participating, well, you should think about trying to participate, because we'd love to have you, at least productively, not, you know, disruptively kind of thing.
Or inanely, like this meeting?
Or inanely, like the last 20 minutes of this meeting. And certainly need more productivity than rainbows and unicorns. Not that there's anything wrong with rainbows and unicorns. All right. That's all I got. Bob, anything else?
Nope. Off to pull requests and bugs and whatnot.
Go get 3.9 done and then figure out how it's going to stabilize, because it took a whole boatload of functionality here at the end.
Yeah. I might blog
about this. Jacob, you do not need a bug request before you submit a PR if it's just good. Unless you want a bug to track the issue, which sometimes has value. You're like, I'd like a bug. I'd like to capture this. By all means, go do that. But we're not going to be pedantic about, hey, look, I found this line of code. It's bad. Go open a bug. No, just fix it. We don't like the pull request. We'll kill it. So, all right. That's it. That's all I got. I will talk to you guys in a week or so, if not sooner, for some of you on the mailing list and things like that, and or in pull requests. Right? Okay, so I think that's it. We'll talk to you guys later. Bye.
Have a good week.